Hello everyone, this is Hoda Genji, and today I want to show you how we can set up some trusses in Revit. We have two roofs here. One of them is a flat roof. The other one is kind of the top off of an irregular shaped mass. So I want to go to Architecture, Roof, Roof by Face, click here and create roof. Okay. In order to have a truss, we need to go to the Structure tab, Truss. There is no trusses loaded yet, so let's do that. I want to go to Structural Trusses folder, which is under Program Data, Libraries, Canada. Okay. I usually go with the Pratt truss. It's a very stable one. If you are not sure yet, you can hit Ctrl A, open, and it will allow you to select the truss that you want later. So it's the Pratt one, that's good. And there are different ways to do this. I have my level 2 here. These two roofs are on level 2. I can go with WT to put the two views next to each other. Let's go to truss, a Pratt truss. You can select maybe one of these corners. It shows it there as well. Now let's see what are the members of this truss. If I click here and go to the edit type, you see some framing types are already assigned to the top chord, this one, to the bottom chord, this one, and to the vertical and diagonal width. Basically, we name the top and the bottom members of the truss as chords, and anything in the middle is named as width. So how can I change them? You see, if I come here and click here, there are not too many options here yet, right? So the way to bring more options here, let's say you want to have a wood truss or a different steel truss, the way to do it is to go to beam. There are actually beam members which show up as the members of the truss. So I can go to the beam, I can go to load family, I need to go one step back so I can bring the structural framing. Maybe a flat bar would be good, or you can search something under the steel tab. We have a flat bar here too. I would go with this one. It looks good as a member of a truss. You can open it. It's going to give you a variety of dimensions. For the top and the bottom chord, we might need a thicker member, a thicker beam. For the ones at the middle, we might need a thinner one. So how about I go with maybe this one, and I want to hold Control and select a couple more elements here. Okay, now three members are uploaded here. I can go to the truss again, click on the truss, go to edit type. You can duplicate it or you can make changes here. I want to assign one of the larger frames to the top and bottom chord. I would select this one for the bottom, for the top, and the same one for the bottom. Go to the structural framing type, click on the right side, and select the member. Again here, I can go with one of the beams in here, apply it, and you see the truss is updated. I want to say OK. And when you work with structural members, it's not a bad idea to go with a fine level of detail so you can see the thickness of the members. Also, I want to draw a section so I can see what's going on. I'll go to View section. Let's take a look at the sections. And again, let's change this to fine for the section as well. Okay, so this is the roof, that's the truss. I want to get some dimensions here. You can type DI, or you can go to annotate, get the dimension from here. I want to see what's the distance between this line and the top of the truss. It's about 1.95. So if I select this truss and change the start level and the end level to negative 1.95, it's gonna move it a little bit down. Now I can select the truss. I can maybe array that, so I can go to array. I want it to be linear, yes. Maybe 6 trusses, or maybe that's too many, 4. And we can go with the last option here. So I want to go from this point to this point, and I want to have 4 items here. I'm gonna switch to this mode and it's gonna be okay. Now let's see how we can create a wood truss. That's basically the same thing. You just need to go to structure, beam, load family, and this time I want to go to structural framing, but I want to go to wood rather than steel. And we have different items here. How about one of the glue lamp ones? This one. Okay. You can go to edit type, you can duplicate it and go with the ones that you are going to use. If you know your manufacturer, you can assign the exact same dimension. I want to go with the one which is 80 by 200. I want to duplicate the existing one. I'll go by 80 by 200. Okay. And I want to change this to 0.08 and 0.2. These are in millimeters, so that's going to be 20 by 8 centimeters. Okay, that seems good. Okay. Now if I select this truss, if I go to edit type, I can change the top chord to one of the glue lamp members, and the bottom chord as well. And I can do the same for the ones at the middle, the webs. It says one or more dimension is going to be invalid. That's good. Delete the dimensions. It's okay. Okay. So that's the way to do it. You see, as I did not duplicate the truss, it changed all of them. You can go with either a wood truss or steel truss. That's the way to do it. Now for this one, it seems a little bit more complicated, and I want to do it in a different way. So let's say I want to have some grids. Maybe I'll go to level 2. Let's see some of the dimensions here. I can go to annotate here to here, 12. Okay, I'm gonna draw a couple of grids, type GR, going maybe from here to here. I can type GR and offset that one by about 3.5 here, here, and here. Okay, so let's say these are gonna be my grids, right? I can again put the two views side by side using WT, the shortcut. And in this one, I can also change this to shaded if it helps, and you can also hide the mask. There we go. So this is the roof. What I want to do is that I want to assign this side of the roof as my reference plane. So I would go to architecture. So let's go to set. I want to pick a plane. Okay. I want this plane and hit show to see the plane. Right. So this is my reference plane. Okay. Now I want to go to structure tab. I want to go to truss. We already have a truss. I'll use the same one. You can pick a line here, or you can draw it. Select the roof. I'm going to come here and I want to move this side of the roof, right? Now, because I have assigned the plane to that corner of the roof, now my reference plane also moved with the roof. I want to delete this and actually create the truss right on the grid. So I'm going to go to truss, pick this line and create it. I want to select the roof again and move this, so it's going to snap. I want to put another truss in here. So truss, just pick this line and I want to continue this process for the other two grids. So select the roof and I want to come here and move this, so it's going to snap on the grid. Structure truss, get this line. And finally the last one, truss, I'm going to get this line. And when it's done, we can go back here and move this back to where it was. If you remember, we had hidden the mask. I can come here, unhide in view element, and now select this roof and update it to face. So now it's the same dimension that it was before. Now the last thing to change is the location of roof. The roof is about 30 centimeters thick, and we switched that truss by 1.95. So if we move the roof by 1.95 plus 30 centimeters, 2.25, it should work properly. There we go. So that's how we can set trusses on either a flat surface or an irregular shaped surface.